Hey y'all, we had a rough week here at Fruitloops HQ, so we weren't able to get a new episode out. But we do have a treat for you. This is one of our extra episodes that we do for our patrons. We hope you enjoy it, and we'll have a new episode next week. But until then, look alive, y'all. It's crazy out there.
This podcast contains adult themes and language, and some of the things that we discuss may be disturbing to some listeners. In this podcast, we discuss sexual assault, torture, race, and murder. Listener discretion is advised. Extra, read all about it. Fruit Loops has some updates for you, and we are gonna shout it. So the first thing I want to say is, fuck you, Zuckerberger, whatever your name is.
What happened?
Well, Facebook went down, and it ruined me and Beth's way to communicate with each other, which was nerve-wracking because there was something important happening at the same time. All my buddies in my WhatsApp group couldn't communicate. It was like,
oh my gosh,
what is happening? And I just, Facebook is not doing great things in terms of the world and battling white supremacy and stuff. And so in that sense, it's good that it went down, and for a moment, those things couldn't perpetuate themselves. But it was really inconvenient, I will say that. I was like, what? Refresh. And then I got the news at the end of the day when it returned, like, oh, that I thought it was my internet. I changed my router. I got a mobile hotspot. I did all kinds of
stuff. Wow.
It was Zuckerberger's fault. So fuck you. Did you hear about the dude who went missing and then he went missing and he joined his own search party when and he realized the person they were looking for in the search party was him.
That's hilarious.
What did he think he was searching for? Let me break it down. So in Ankara, Turkey, a scene worthy of a comedy sketch, I say, agree. A Turkish man joined a search party after a missing person, not realizing he was actually the one they were searching for. The man's name is Behan Mutlu, and he had been drinking quite a lot with friends on Tuesday when he wandered into a forest in a province somewhere, and I think he fell asleep in a house.
Passed out.
Yeah, he passed out. And when he failed to return, his wife and friends were like, what's going on? So they called the authorities, and a search party was sent out. Now, 50-year-old Mutlu woke up from
he
being passed
know better.
Out.
He's 50.
I know, right? It's a pandemic. Like, none of us are ourselves right now, right? So Mutlu, 50 years old, stumbles across the search party looking for somebody, and he's like, I'm gonna help. So he joins them. He joins the search team with such ving and vigor, just aggressively searching for this missing person to help whoever needs help. But when the members of the search party started calling his name, he replied, I'm here.
In the search party. Oh my God, that's hilarious.
So the search was over, and boy, oh boy, was this a funny story. Oh, I love it. Yes, I'm so glad you did.
Like, it could be it could even be a movie or something.
Yes, I know. Like, dude, where's my car? Only a little bit more interesting. Yeah.
Dude, where's me?
Yeah. So, my next story, and I was wondering if you heard about the story about a university in the Boston area. We've talked about how racist the Boston area historically has been, that a bunch of white students wrote a letter specifically only to black students. And I guess it happened at UMass at the Black Student Union. They posted a message.
They wrote a message to just the black students?
Yeah, I think at the Black Student Union, they posted it either on the message board physically or the message board online.
Okay.
I guess in addition to this, the Black Student Union organizations have been getting racist emails for weeks. And
about what? I mean, that, there's no excuse.
There is no excuse.
There is no excuse, but what the hell?
There is absolutely. That's why she's my favorite white lady. I can't say that enough. They were saying things like, you don't belong here.
What?
You're disgusting. Let me see if I can pull up the messages.
Oh my God.
Let's see. Blatantly racist emails. And I don't want to traumatize anybody. I'm trying to see if. I haven't actually been able to find copies of the emails themselves, just reports on it, because the Black student organizations were complaining like, hey, university, we're paying gazillions of dollars to be here and be safe. Here it is. Herein lays the problem with your presence at our college. You simply did not get here on merit. White people, Asians, Hispanics, none of us truly want to interact with you.
Oh, my God.
We only do so because it's required.
Oh my God.
Yeah. And I think that's just, yeah, fuck them. Absolutely. But also fuck the university for their slow response. At first the university did nothing. And then when social media was like, this is some bullshit.
This is a problem.
Then they were like, you know what? This is bullshit. We are going to investigate so hard.
and then they didn't investigate.
That's pretty much where it's been left. There's a lot of outrage, but little to no action. And you know, you go to college to learn about yourself, to learn about other people, to learn about new things, and to have their students blatantly say we only have to interact with you because we are required is a failure on the university, failure on the admissions people. I mean, for letting a caliber of people like that into the school. It's a teaching opportunity. It's a learning opportunity. I really hope that the UMass does something about it.
Yeah, if they don't, that's bullshit.
It is. And I think people also think that racism isn't that bad if it doesn't kill you.
Yeah, that's
but
bullshit.
It's not.
Rape isn't that bad if it doesn't kill you.
Right? Yes, thank you. Oh my God, Beth, how do you do this every time? How are you this wonderful of a white
it's
person?
Common sense.
I almost can't even believe that you are my white friend because you just get it. Yeah.
It's just common sense.
Because you don't die doesn't mean that it's not harmful.
Doesn't hurt you.
Or hurtful. And something should be done about it.
Absolutely.
My next story is about Miya Marcano. Have you heard about her?
I have.
This one is a sad one. Now, she was a 19-year-old girl in Orlando, Florida, and she's part of the Trinidadian community, so shout out to my Caribbean peoples. Miya went missing at the end of September, and it turns out she was abducted, and she was found murdered, according to Orange County Sheriff John Mina. Her body was found near an Orlando apartment complex last week, and the person of interest was a maintenance man at her apartment, and he had made a bunch of romantic advances towards her, and she turned him down. One report I saw said that she filed it like an order of protection. It's not quite a restraining order against him, and Marcano, she lived in this really nice apartment complex, and she also worked there in Orlando. And she was found at a different apartment complex 18 miles away from her home.
Wow.
And her purse and ID were located on her body. Cell phone records indicated that Armando Manuel Caballero is the person of interest identified. And he committed suicide.
Yeah.
In his apartment. So,
yeah. Fuck you guys. Allegedly.
I forgot we have to say that. Yeah.
Yeah, well, he's dead, so pretty sure he did it.
All the evidence does seem to suggest, because he even told the police, you know, they asked him, have you seen her? And he said, oh, I saw her on the last day that she was alive, around that 3 p.m. that afternoon. Well, it turns out, because of his occupation, he has a master key to all of the apartments.
Right.
And those fobs keep records, y'all, which is a good thing. Yeah, so the record, the metadata from the fob indicates that he was in her room, or he used it to enter her room.
To get in her apartment.
So an arrest warrant has been issued. or I'm sorry, no arrest warrant because he committed suicide. But he had a pattern of breaking into people's rooms. And there was a burglary charge or warrant for his arrest on
burglary. And he's still working there?
He was still working there. Wasn't that wild? So,
Very wild. Yeah.
I'm glad that I saw the Caballero, or not the Caballero, the Miya Marcano, 19 years old story in the mainstream news.
I saw a lot of articles about it. Yeah. That was good.
Yeah. And I think it probably led to the closure of the case sooner versus later, because there are hundreds of thousands of Black and Brown missing women all over the United States. And this is a sign that people are paying attention. So what else did I want to talk to you about? Okay. Well, I'm not sure how long I've been talking, mostly because we did something before we went on.
Before we recorded. Tell me one more.
Okay, let's see. This one is kind of a happy story. So, in Queensland, Australia, Indigenous land has been returned to the Indigenous people. Can you believe it?
But I'm happy to hear it.
I know. I'm so happy. Let me get into it. So some of Australia's world-famous national parks have been returned to the hands of Indigenous owners after a deal was negotiated with the government. This deal took 4 years. The Indigenous people did not relent. And thank goodness the colonial powers that be in the Australian government were willing to listen. Yeah. The deal was signed last month with members of the Eastern Kuku Yalanji community and the government. And it involves four national parks that were returned to the owners of the land. And I'm glad the article said it that way. Now, the area includes Daintree National Park, a UNESCO World Heritage Site that is estimated to be around 130 million years old. Wow. The land given back totals more than 395,000 acres in Northern Australia.
Wow. Yes. That's awesome.
And again, it took them years to negotiate this with the Queensland government. Apparently, this is fascinating.
Awesome.
Yes, I wanted to say a little bit more about this culture. Eastern Kuku Yalanji culture is one of the oldest living cultures in the world, dating back 50,000 years in the area.
What?
Yeah, and Aboriginal Australians have the longest continual living culture in the fucking world.
Wow.
And if you think about it, white people have only been the boss for 400. So win. Anyway, the agreement recognizes their right to own their own country, to protect their own culture and share with visitors. And eventually they will be able to take it over completely, be the sole managers of the land. Let's see. The government in Australia admitted that they have an uncomfortable and ugly past. No shit. And, the story goes the British colonized the area, claimed it, even though people already lived there, and then moved the Aboriginal people from their homes, segregated them, and then also frequently removed their children. And we see this in the United States and in Canada, too. The Indigenous children are used as pawns. So the Indigenous people will say, no, don't take my children. And then the colonizer says, if you don't give me your children, it's your children or your land. Which one do you want? And they take the land.
Of course.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So the Indigenous. Awful. Yeah, totally. They're still suffering from the effects of colonialism, which are terrible. Yeah. But this is a good step toward reconciliation between colonizers, governments, and its Indigenous people. And I thought that was good news. And the ancestors, the tribes people or the Indigenous tribe members said that they felt like this was their ancestors calling them back home. And I just thought that was so beautiful.
Yeah, that is beautiful.
Yeah. What do you got, Beth?
Well, did you hear this story? Did you read this story or see the headline? The headline was "Professor Suspended for Not Giving Black Students Easier Final Exams."
No. Okay. I don't know what to make of that headline.
Yeah, I was like, what?
What does that mean?
So I read the article and that didn't happen.
What?
Wait a minute.
Isn't journalism supposed to be better than that?
Yeah,
what happened?
You would think so. This was in Newsweek, right?
Okay.
So I'm like, this is a reputable source, right?
Yeah.
But that's not what happened. If you read the story, and I actually had to Google it because this infuriated me.
Yeah.
And I was like, okay, what's
absolutely,
the story?
Rightfully so.
What's
this
the
is,
story?
Yeah. Yeah. Tell me, Morning so, Glory, what is the story?
The story is this douchebag, Gordon Klein is Gordon his name. Klein. He's okay. a professor at UCLA.
Okay.
He teaches financial analysis, law, and public policy.
Okay.
And so this was around when George Floyd was killed and okay. the riots and stuff. Mm-hmm. And so a well-meaning white person or somebody who's not Black,
uh-huh.
I guess there was several of them got together and they emailed him asking him to give, you know, make it easier for the Black students when they take their final exam, either, you know, grade on a curve or, you
know. Given the collective trauma that they might have experienced
right,
as a
exactly.
result of seeing and somebody kill another Black person for
right.
1 minute. Yes. Okay. Got
right.
it. Okay.
So, the email was asking something, could you do this?
Okay.
And instead of saying like, no, actually I can't do that. I mean, what he could have done was made it easier for all of the students, but he actually could not have just made it easier for the Black students. He just, that would not be.
Is that not ethical or something?
It's not. Well, it's, I don't want to say it's against the law because it's not the law. It's like uh-huh. the school's.
Oh, the school's policy.
Right, the school's policy.
Oh,
so he
okay.
couldn't have done it.
Okay.
But, you know, instead of saying, sorry, I can't do that, I understand mm-hmm. your opinion or whatever, blah, 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 he emailed back this douchebag
Uh-oh.
Email.
Oh,
yeah.
no. Insert face in palm. What
yeah.
did he say?
Let me see.
Do we want to know?
It was it was infuriating.
Oh, boy.
Yeah. I mean, some of it was just typical, I'm an asshole professor
uh-huh.
kind of stuff.
Yeah.
But some of it was just ugh, gross.
Oh, boy.
He said, are there any students that may be of mixed parentage, such as half Black, half Asian? What do you suggest I do with respect to them? A full concession or just half? Also, do you have any idea if there are any students from Minneapolis? I assume that they probably especially devastated as well. I'm thinking that a white student from there might possibly be even more devastated by this, especially because some might think that they're racist, even if they're not.
Oh, my God. I can
yeah.
think of a million responses other than that one.
Other than that. Yeah. I mean, apparently it was a pretty long email.
Oh, well,
and
he's
it was
a professor.
Just,
I'm sure
yeah.
he thinks every word
is
priceless.
Precious.
Yes.
Yeah. and so what the school did, I mean, after the students, I guess they made the email public.
Okay.
And there
Good.
Was a backlash.
Yeah,
and
of course.
People were calling for him to be fired.
Okay.
And what the school did was they suspended him for 3 weeks. And so that's it, you know.
That's it.
That's
oh,
it.
That's
and
a
so
teachable
he...
moment. They blew it. What's wrong with these universities?
So now he's suing the school.
What?
Yeah.
The he's teacher?
Saying, yeah, the teacher's suing the school.
You're fucking
he's saying,
kidding me.
He's saying that he suffered severe emotional distress, trauma, and physical ailments for which he has
wow.
been treated by his primary care physician, a gastrointestinal physician, and a psychiatrist.
Oh.
And that to that, I say, boo, who?
Who, motherfucking
fuck you,
who?
Asshole.
Wow. So everybody, and I don't think the students made a mistake. I think
they
was well-intentioned.
It was well-intentioned.
And it
yeah.
would have been an opportunity for the professors or anybody at that university's leadership to say, maybe I can't do this, but here's some support and resources
yeah.
that the university can provide for anybody, especially our Black students who are experiencing trauma as a result of this. All of
right.
this is just... I'm putting up my hands. Nope, not me. it's just so, it's tone deaf and really in just gross. I can't think of another word for it.
Yeah.
Just all of it is gross. What university is this? So I can never go there and we can never do a live show.
It was UCLA.
Okay. You know, so, some of my family members graduated from there. I don't give a fuck.
Well, it's supposed to be a good school, but obviously.
Allegedly.
Yeah. Allegedly.
Yeah. They should know better.
It infuriated me, not just his bullshit, but this article, which did not tell the full story.
Right.
And put the focus on the saying that he was suspended for not giving Black students easier final exams, which wasn't even true.
Mm-hmm.
That wasn't why he was suspended. Mm-hmm. He was suspended because of the
his response was very poor and unprofessional.
And so I put on my Karen hat.
You did. Okay, and what happened when you did that?
I emailed Newsweek and I told them that their article was bullshit.
Oh my. Beth, I was going to just pretend to like fall out of my chair, but I just did it for real.
And you know what? They changed the name of the article. No! They didn't change much else, but...
Oh my God! She did it again!
I don't know if I did it or not. Other people might have done the same thing, but I was just furious.
My glory tears back. I wish you were in my room so I could hug you. That is so wonderful, Beth. I'm so glad. I'm happy you did that and recognized it. And... Man, I'm without you. Literally, my breath is gone. I can't say any. Oh my God. Wow. You did that.
So I was looking at the comments and everybody's like, you know, I can't believe that he got suspended for not letting them, you know, whatever.
Miss
they're like
me with that.
No, you didn't even read the article, you dumb fuck, or you didn't look into it.
Yes, but made me so leave mad. It up to Beth to read the article and then do research about it and then contact the publishers. Yo, wow.
It's fucking Newsweek, man.
Oh my God.
Don't put that shit out there.
Oh, Lord have mercy, Beth. I just applaud you. And you're just amazing at everything you do. What's next? Can you walk on water? What's next? You've been to the moon? What's next? You're richer than Jeff Bezos? What?
Have you seen that commercial with the lady? She's like looking at the moon.
Thinking about it? I don't think so.
I can't even remember what it's for. That's the problem with commercials. I remember the funny commercials, but I don't remember what they're for.
Oh,
she's
man.
Like, she's thinking and she's like, why do horses listen to us? They're so much bigger than we are. But they can't go to the moon. We went to the moon. I bet riding a horse on the moon would be awesome.
Wow. Wow. The thought process.
Yeah, she's just sitting there and you're hearing her thoughts.
You know what I bet?
Like, that's me.
I know. I was going to say, did they copy that from my brain? It's probably it sounds like it would be an insurance commercial. I say that as I'm in my closet looking at my flow from Progressive
flow
Halloween
costume.
Yeah.
So my next story is about a body, actually two bodies.
Oh, like body, yaddy, yaddy, body, yaddy, 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 yaddy.
No, actual dead bodies.
Oh, okay. Yeah. Forgot. True crime. Okay, go ahead.
True crime, yeah. So they found two dead bodies in Portland.
Did they now? Okay.
Yeah.
Go on.
In a wooded area. So they found, somebody found a skull.
Okay.
And they're like, there's a skull. So they went to, the investigators went to search the area to find the rest of the body, I guess, and came across another body.
Really?
Yeah.
Oh boy. Well, this sounds serious.
Yeah. And the sheriff was asked if it was suspicious.
Oh,
he
God.
He said, absolutely.
Oh, God. Okay. Okay.
And so, then, I think that's all I got on that one.
Oh, my. I found a body. It's suspicious.
It's
suspicious. Okay.
Two bodies. Yeah.
Two bodies.
Usually I write out like stuff that happened. I just kind of
jot notes,
paste.
Yeah, I actually copied you because I saw you do that, and now I do it too. So all thank
right,
you.
Awesome. So wait, it says Sheriff James Quattrone said it was too early to tell whether the events leading up to the discoveries are related. However, asked if they were treating the recovery of the human remains both found near a trail off of Woolabin Road in Portland as suspicious. And he said, absolutely. Yeah.
Okay.
So that's it.
I had a Portland story.
Did you?
Also, well, not Portland, Bend, Oregon, but a white guy shot a black guy at a bar when the black guy said, "Oh, hi, girlfriend," and paid her a compliment. And the white guy got furious and shot the black dude in Bend, Oregon. I wanted to piggyback off of your story because the history of Oregon should not be forgotten. Oregon was a whites only state until 1926.
I remember you told me that. Yeah.
And so I
that's nuts.
Yeah, it is nuts. I don't know if the bodies were people of color or anything like that in your story, but we see you, Oregon, and you have a lot of explaining to do and fixing to do. So
yeah, they haven't identified the bodies yet, so okay. They just found them.
Okay, got it.
Yeah, yeah. So did you hear the story about the guy who stole diapers?
No, but that's a crime. That's a crime of struggle. He should have.
Right.
Did he go to
well,
jail?
What happened was.
Okay.
This is in Winter Haven, Florida, which, by the way, is where my mother was born.
Get out of here.
Yeah.
Wow. Okay.
So in Winter Haven, Florida, a guy went into Walmart and he had two kids and he went to buy some diapers and his two credit cards were declined.
Oh.
So he left, but then he came back without the kids and grabbed the diapers and took off.
Okay.
And the police posted about it on Facebook.
Okay.
And they posted his picture and asked anyone recognize him and said that he stole diapers. Mm-hmm. And a 16-year-old named Elizabeth Fiedler, who lives in Kansas, said she felt really sad for the man in the photo and commented on Facebook that she would pay for the diapers as long as they leave this man alone.
Mm.
And that post was shared several thousand times and more than 4,500 people weighed in saying that they were also offended and upset by the police.
Yes.
Commenting about how it's cold and heartless. The man is just trying to take care of his children.
Uh-huh.
Have some compassion.
Yeah.
People saying they'd pay for the diapers and all this stuff. And I just thought it was kind of a heartwarming story that all these people were
doing the right thing.
Yeah. Yeah. How heartwarming.
Wait a minute. Humanity, you mean? Yeah. What's that?
It's nice to see.
I can't believe it.
And then Walmart, they decided not to charge the guy.
Wow.
Well, they signed a waiver of prosecution.
Okay.
And then the police contacted the man because I guess they found out who he was.
Okay.
Explained to him that Walmart's not going to press charges, and then they provided a list of local organizations that might be able to help him. So,
okay, that's good. That's
good.
That is
nice
heartwarming.
Story, right?
They could have donated a bunch of. If the police department wants to change their reputation, what they should have did was donated a bunch of diapers to the dude and like food for the family and like got it all caught on camera and stuff, posted it to their social media. Now everybody hates this police department too. I know I do. But that is a heartwarming story. I'm glad it.
And with a nice outcome.
Yeah. A nice outcome.
So keep it up, people.
Yeah. Look at people being good and stuff. Wow. Wow.
I got one more story for you.
Okay.
This one's about a tarantula that was spotted on top of a house in California.
Oh my God. I saw this story. I didn't read the article, of course.
Okay.
But
all right.
Tell me about it.
Here we go. Animal rescuers in California were called out to assist a tarantula spotted stranded on the roof of a home.
No!
Yeah, it's a stranded tarantula. The Peninsula Humane Society said an animal control officer was dispatched to a San Mateo neighborhood to check on the tarantula. Okay. The officer received permission from the homeowners to attempt a rescue and climbed up to the roof with a plastic enclosure to capture the spider. The Humane Society said in a Facebook post that the officer quickly discovered it was actually a Halloween decoration, not a pet tarantula.
Oh my God, that is so beautiful. Happy Halloween, bitches.
Yeah, happy Halloween.
Oh my God. Can you imagine if the police showed up to your house because of some decorations?
And well, and I guess they didn't even know it was up there.
Who is the person that called?
Neighbor. I think a neighbor called, and then the homeowners didn't even know it was up there. So either that or they were playing a joke on the guy. Who knows?
Maybe, but that's so ridiculous to call about a spider. Also, tarantulas are good pets. For the record,
so.
I would never own one, but right. My understanding is that they can be very docile, very interesting, and stay
I like
tuned
to look at them.
I think my offspring wants one for Christmas.
Wants one, so. Yeah. I like to look at them, like at the zoo, they have some, you know, but they're behind glass, and
yeah.
I don't have to
have
take it
home. Have you ever held
home,
one
so.
In your hand?
Oh, no. Oh, no.
No.
I like to look at them, but no.
Oh,
no.
Yeah. I remember holding one in my hand and just being like terrified and mesmerized at the same time, and I'll never forget that feeling.
I don't know if I want it again, but I'll never forget it.
I remember the petting zoo guy saying, oh yeah, they bite, but it doesn't hurt that bad.
Oh God. Oh boy.
So and they Yikes. Do cool things, like they molt and oh, you know. But I love that story. I love weird what
animal
weird
stories
like that. Yeah. Well, oh, geez, look at the time. But this was fantastic. That's the news. Look alive, y'all. It's crazy out there.